I'm Dr. Schmidt, and I've been in practice about 24 years. I specialize in shoulder and elbow surgery. Started at University of Wisconsin, and that's where I went to medical school. I went to, you know, University of Pittsburgh for residency, general surgery and orthopedics, surgical internship. And I did a lab year there. Went to University of Indiana for upper extremity fellowship. And I've been in Pittsburgh back here about 20 years, and I specialize again in shoulder and elbow surgery. I run the shoulder and elbow fellowship, Department of Orthopedic Surgery here at Pittsburgh. And I also take part and co-direct a laboratory just devoted to shoulder and elbow surgery. Shoulder arthritis, what it really is that it's the deterioration of the gliding surface of the joint. And it gets bone on bone arthritis. And what happens is our bodies compensate by producing osteophytes. So the shape of the bone changes. So the shape, instead of being round, turns out to be a square. And so you could think about it in life, when you have a round ball, it can move in many directions. But when you have a square object, it can't move anymore. So what happens is the shape of the bone changes and deteriorates. And so patients get pain because of there's no cartilage. They also get pain because you have a square peg and a round socket, and it just crunches and it cracks and it hurts. There's different types of shoulder arthritis. You can have a glenohumeral arthritis, which is like a wear and tear of your shoulder. And then you can have like arthritis from rotator cuff deficiency, and it's called, you know, rotator cuff arthropathy. And nowadays, you know, a lot of that time we could treat it conservatively, and if conservative treatment doesn't work, we'll do a shoulder replacement. And the technology for shoulder replacement is greatly expanded. We're doing less invasive shoulder replacements. We're using, you know, short stems. We're using, you know, stemless implants, and we're using reverse shoulder arthroplasties. The first line of treatment should be, you know, non-operative care. You know, and some of that is just behavior modification. And it could be, you know, aspirin at works and non-steroidals. And sometimes if they have intact rotator cuff and they have deformity, maybe viscosupplements could work. And what that is it's like a lubrication. We inject in the shoulder and it makes the shoulder move smoothly and they have less pain. And that, I've had patients have success with that up to a year. And then they come in and we give them another viscosupplement. I have a lot of young people in their 40s with significant glenohumeral arthritis that maybe don't qualify for total shoulder arthroplasty, or it's not as bad, but they want to still live an active life, and I've been doing that. And also I have elderly people that just don't want to take the time to get a joint placement. Now, sometimes it doesn't work, and the end game sometimes is shoulder surgery, you know, with replacement surgery, whether it's a total shoulder surgery or reverse shoulder surgery. If you have reverse shoulder surgery, the recovery is a little bit quicker than a total shoulder surgery. In reverse shoulder surgery, you know, it's usually they wear a sling at night just to protect it so they don't dislocate early, and that's for 6 weeks. During the day, I let them like eat, use their hand to eat, brush their teeth. They get these exercise program, and they can use their arm as long as they don't lift greater than 5 pounds of their arm. I'm okay with it. So pretty much the next 2 days after surgery, when I feel comfortable, they can start actively using their arm. And then at 6 weeks, they go to therapy and start strengthening their arm. And then at 3 months, they're pretty happy. And usually it's about 3 to 6 months recovery. And then I see them every year after that, make sure that the implant looks good with an x-ray. Where total shoulder is, you have to protect the rotator cuff. So for 6 weeks, pretty much they can shower, but they're in a sling. But I give them some exercise, they do. And then at 6 weeks, they start therapy. So there's a difference in the type, a difference in recovery depending on what shoulder replacement I put in. So the rehab after a shoulder replacement just depends on, you know, what type of shoulder replacement. The total shoulder replacement requires a good rotator cuff. So it's gonna be a little bit longer than a reverse shoulder replacement. In a reverse shoulder replacement, I keep the rotator cuff, but the implant itself takes stress off the cuff. So I feel comfortable with a reverse shoulder replacement, letting people move the next day after surgery. They have to sleep in a sling, but they can do anything they want to do, they're comfortable with, as long as they don't lift 5 pounds. And then 6 weeks they go to therapy, and in fact, some people don't even need therapy. They just get it, and they start using their shoulder right away. On a total shoulder replacement, I have to protect the rotator cuff for 6 weeks. They have to be in a sling for 6 weeks. for 6 weeks. So if they want early recovery, and it's really critical for them, you know, a root shoulder replacement is probably the way to go. If they can give time and they want a little more rotation, maybe a total shoulder is the way to go. But in order for a total shoulder replacement to work, they have to have a good rotator cuff. If they don't, then a reverse shoulder replacement's a good option, and they can get a still a good result. So sometimes early intervention, it doesn't really do any good. There's nothing that I know of that can cure, you know, shoulder arthritis. We believe it's genetic, and it's a slowly deterioration of the joint.